referred us to the statement on their website which says about allegations of mistreatment, that is not true. It was the sheriff's deputies who executed the search warrant of the Neverland Ranch.
How did you feel when they went into Neverland? I mean, with the search warrant. I mean, what were they looking for? What did they take?
My room is a complete wreck. My workers told me, they said, Michael, don't go in your room. They were crying on the phone, my employees. They said, if you saw your room, you would cry. I have stairs that go up to my bed. And they said, you can't even get up the stairs. The room is totally trashed. And they had 80 policemen in this room, 80 policemen in one bedroom. That's really overdoing it. And they took knives and cut open my mattresses with knives. Just cut everything open.
Did they take anything from Neverland?
I'm not sure what they took. They never gave me a list.
But you're saying that they destroyed your property?
Yes, they did. And then what they did was, they made everybody that worked at the property, they locked everybody out of the house. They had the whole house to themselves to do whatever they wanted. And they totally took advantage. They went into areas they weren't supposed to go into, like my office. They didn't have search warrants for those places. And they totally took advantage. And the room is a total, total wreck, they told me. And I don't think I want to see it. I'm not ready to see it yet.
So you haven't been back there?
I've been back there, but not in my bedroom. I won't live there ever again. I'll visit Neverland. It's a house now. It's not a home anymore. I'll only visit there. What time is it? Because I'm hurting. I don't feel good.
In a moment, Michael Jackson tells us why he still believes it's appropriate to have children sleep in his bed. And he lashes out at the family whose child he's accused of sexually molesting. This is not the first time Michael Jackson has been accused of child molestation. 10 years ago, he was accused of sexually abusing another young boy. However, after that boy refused to testify, and after Jackson paid the boy's family millions of dollars to settle a civil lawsuit, Jackson was never charged. Although the family in the current case against him has filed no lawsuit and says it does not intend to, Michael Jackson is still suspicious of their motives.
Greed, money, somewhere greed got in there and somebody, I can't quite say, but it has to do with money. It's Michael Jackson, look what we have here, we get money out of this. That's exactly what happened.
What I don't understand is why today, and I know you say it's money, but who? I mean, why would he turn around and say, Michael Jackson sexually molested me, if it weren't true?
Because parents have power over children. They feel they have to do what their parents say. But money is the root of all evil, as you know. The love of money is the root of all evil. And this is a sweet child. And to see him turn like this, this isn't him. This is not him.
So you don't think this comes from him, this comes from his parents?
No, this is not him, no. I know his heart.
Three.
So if you were innocent, why would you pay? I mean, to keep it quiet. I mean, why not go into court and fight for your good name?
I'm not allowed to talk on that.
Sure.
There we go.
Jackson's attorney, Mark Garagos, told me that if I wanted an answer to that question, I'd have to ask him.
I mean, remember what happened to him 10 years ago. He was humiliated. He went through where somebody was examining him, was photographing him, was having him, humiliating him in the worst way in terms of looking at his private parts and photographing his private parts. And he was subjected to some of the most just intrusive kinds of things that you could ever imagine. I can only try to put myself into that situation and say, look, if money could make that situation go away, maybe that was the calculus then. I don't know, and I don't want to second guess it.
But what you end up with is the public perception that this has happened not once, this has happened twice, that young boys have come forward to accuse him of of sexual molestation over the last 10 years. And he has made public comments about how he enjoys sharing his bed with children. Can you understand how the public might feel that, hey, maybe there's something here, there's a lot of smoke?
Well, look, there's a lot of smoke, but I think it's a lot of the people who blow the smoke are twisting what's happened. I understand when people say now there's somebody else who came forward, but I think, in all fairness, most people get it. Most people understand that this case is not about anything but money.
We asked the mother of the accuser who made these latest allegations to tell us her side of the story, but she declined and would not authorize anyone else to speak on her behalf.
That British documentary last February, which you didn't like.
Yeah, I didn't like it.
You said in that documentary that many children have slept in your bedroom. You said,
yes.
And I'm going to quote here, why can't you share your bed? The most loving thing to do is to share your bed with someone.
Yes.
As we sit here today, do you still think that it's acceptable to share your bed with children?
Of course. Of course, why not? If you're going to be a pedophile, if you're going to be Jack the Ripper, if you're going to be a murderer, it's not a good idea. That I'm not. That's how we were raised. And I didn't sleep in the bed with the child. Even if I did, it's okay. I slept on the floor. I gave the bed to the child.
But given all that you've been through,
yeah,
given the allegations, given the innuendo, why would you put yourself in a position where something like this could happen again?
Well, I'm always more cautious, but I would never stop helping and loving people the way Jesus said to. He said, continue to love, always love, bring on the children, imitate the children, not childish, but childlike.
That may sound naive, but Jackson attorney Mark Garrigo says they did take precautions.
They were at all times during that February 7th to March 10th period of time. Whenever Michael was there, there was always a third party around. Always.
What about the allegation that some kind of intoxicating agent, said to be wine, was given to this child to make him more pliable?
Ludicrous. I mean, it's ludicrous on its face. There are in excess of 100 employees at any one time at that ranch. There is full-time security at that ranch. There are people who are there at all times, day and night, 24/7, who are specifically instructed to make sure that people don't do that. The kids are nowhere near alcohol or liquor.
You're a parent. You've got three children.
Yes.
Would you allow your children to sleep in the bed with a grown man who was not a relative, or to sleep in the bedroom?
Sure. If I know that person, trust them, and love them. That's happened many times with me when I was little.
Would you, as a parent, allow your children to sleep in the same bedroom with someone who has the suspicions and allegations that have been made against you and about you today? Would you allow that?
Someone...
If you knew someone who had the same kind of allegations...
Yeah, I know exactly what you're saying.
Would you let your children,
my children,
sleep in that man's bedroom?
If I knew the person personally, because I know how the press is, I know how people can twist the truth. If I knew the person personally, absolutely yes. Mm. Absolutely. I wouldn't have a problem with it.
Do you know how this looks to a lot of people? I mean, do you understand that?
How does what look?
How the fact that you...
No, why? People think sex. They're thinking sex. My mind doesn't run that way. When I see children, I see the face of God. That's why I love them so much. That's what I see.
His Thriller CD topped the charts, while his latest didn't crack the top 10.
What has this done to your career?
What has it done to my career?
What has it done to your career?
In what way?
How has it impacted, touring, record
sales? My album's number one all over the world. All over the world. America's the only one because, I don't want to say too much.
But it's not number one in the United States.
It's conspiracy, yeah. I don't want to say too much. I'm done. I don't want to say much because I'm hurting. I'm really hurting.
One last question.
Michael, what would you say to your fans who have supported you
through all of this and who today, some of them might have questions. What would you say to them?
Well, I would tell them I love them very much. And they've learned about me and know about me from a distance. But if you really want to know about me, there's a song I wrote, which is the most honest song I've ever written. It's the most autobiographical song I've ever written. It's called Childhood.
Have you seen my childhood?
They should listen to it. That's the one they really should listen to. And thank you for your support, the fans around the world. I love you with all my heart.
The pain for you I've had.
I don't take any of it for granted, any of it. And I love them dearly, all over the world.
Have you seen my child?
Michael Jackson will make his first appearance in court on January 16th when he is arraigned. He is expected to plead not guilty.